I began to memorize scripture in volumes of it my last year in high school. And it was because a youth group leader challenged me to get into God's word and then be accountable to share what I'd learned with others. I panicked and thought, oh my goodness, I'm gonna have to give this a real shot. And I'd been, I think, a believer before that, didn't really have assurance, didn't see a lot of fruit in my own life. However, having been challenged to get into God's word, simply reading it and studying it, God's word began to grip me and the Holy Spirit started to work in my life and I began to change that I myself could see. At that point, as a young 17, 18 year old, I just fell in love with God's word. And so reading it, studying it, and memorizing it all went hand in hand. Plus, I wanted to share God's word with others. So that's where it started. My motivation to work with John and learning scripture memory together, and it would have been criminal not to. It had become a basic building block in my own Christian life. It would have been strange not to have worked at and been intentional about encouraging my kids to memorize scripture as well. So it's something that, because it emanated from my life authentically, not practicing what the verses said necessarily, but working at memorizing them, to then lead them in that endeavor with me was kind of a no-brainer. When John, his sisters were quite young, we worked through an ABC of Bible verses, 26 of them, one for each letter of the alphabet. But John and I began in his very young teen years, maybe even before that, to work really specifically at the Navigator's topical memory system and the 60 verses there. And it was a project that took months and years, but we started early and just kept slugging away at it.
It didn't matter at times whether I was interested or not interested. It was more, like he said, it's about faith, trusting that his word will have an impact on our lives. And it did. It was just a matter of the review. I think that was such an important element for, you know, about it for us. We kept at it every day so that you don't just lose it. And that way it's stayed in my heart for years and years.
Therefore, if any man be in Christ,
he is a new creation. The old is gone, the new has come.
2 Corinthians 5:17. As far as the tangible, observable benefits that I saw in John as we memorized scripture together, I would say not necessarily did I see a lot in terms of, wow, you know, instant spiritual growth, any more than I've seen it in my own life. It was more of an investment in faith, knowing that God's word says, hey, this is seed, plant it. How it's going to bear fruit is up to God, but, you know, it doesn't happen apart from some diligence. So we just worked at it, and eventually I believe it's borne fruit in his life and in mine.
There's a lot of good ways to do it. I think the biggest thing is just start. You can find apps on your phone that are free that are very easy to use. You can look up scripture memory songs on YouTube, and there's songs, which is a good introductory way to start with kids, because songs are easy to memorize. But then the more you get into it, the more you find tools. I've seen adults who have started just in the past several months, and they're making it happen because they're doing it. But accountability helps as well. And so have somebody with you who's going to work at it with you. That's going to make a big difference as well. The best thing about working with my children is just knowing that they're hiding God's word in their heart. I don't know that there's a better feeling for me. It's exciting to know that maybe it's not truly transforming them in this moment, but it will just continue to bear fruit in their lives, and trusting that. It's being obedient to God's word myself as a parent to raise them up in the word and for them to hide it in their hearts. And so when they can then recite that back and talk about it, and then even sometimes talk about what it means to them, there's just nothing better. I know it's going to last forever.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life.
Nice.